European Union is not just that it is conjecturally neoliberal. It has an embedded neoliberalism. It has an embedded neoliberalism since the mid-1980s, since the Single European Act. It is also highly undemocratic. And it is also an imperialist formation in the sense that hegemonic European Union countries get a comparative advantage against other countries. Moreover, it imposes, especially in its current version, a condition of limited sovereignty. You cannot avoid austerity measures if you have the Eurogroup controlling monetary policy, if the European Central Bank is controlling the liquidity of the banks, and if you remain dependent upon loans from the ECB and the IMF. So it's not about the currency. It's about regaining economic and therefore monetary sovereignty in a social and democratic way. That means having an ability to impose an alternative policy.